So I've created a little experiment with my Legacy of the Wizard editor. Here I'm taking Xemn out for a spin with his glove. And over here, I've created a very special block for him to push. So I push this, and in behind, we get another block. And we have infinite blocks now. Which, if I do this carefully, I can reach that treasure chest up there. Oops. I always forget all the rules for pushing the blocks. It's very complicated. Or not so much complicated as difficult to remember what your last relevant button press was. I think we're making progress though. I think we just need one more block on that group there. Let's see what we can do with this. Should maybe unhand the glove. Okay. So let's see. What do we want to do here? Exactly what I wanted to do. Okay. And now Xemn gets the wings. He can bring them home to Mena. So to explain what I did here, I edited the first room, just threw all these enemies in the corner. But I placed a block, and what I did was I made the block replacement tile, this little cloud-looking thing, and I made it so the secret tile is the cloud-looking thing, so whenever you touch it, it gets replaced by another block. I originally tried replacing a block with a block, but apparently it doesn't let you push it if you do that. But doing this let you create as many as you want. So I hope that was interesting. I really like how this game works. There's a lot of curious possibilities, especially in the secret wall functions.